In terms of our current season, obviously Lewis, four-time champion now. Do you think that does make him the best ever? Or I mean, because there's a debate. Obviously, Michael's won more, but Lewis, you know.
I mean, he's without doubt the best British driver of all time. And that's just astonishing. Michael Schumacher's obviously a way off in terms of his win rate and his world championship titles. But Lewis is on course for it. I mean, he's still only 32, so who knows? He may well emulate the great Michael Schumacher yet.
I think obviously over the last few years we've seen, particularly with a lot of the changes in engine requirements and things coming in, it was designed to make the sport more competitive after a period of Red Bull dominance. Do you think that has worked out? Because I think initially fans were a little worried that all it had really done had shifted that dominance to Mercedes for a few years.
I think all these things are cyclical. Every team's going to hit a purple patch and run with it. I think that's inevitable. The other inevitability is the bigger the budget you've got, the more that you can, more resource that you can use. But I think we should take great heart from the likes of Force India, who are punching well above their weight, you know, secured their places fourth in the constructors, and with very limited resource and budget. So it can be done, and I think actually this season's proved that Formula One's a thrilling place to be, and you know, edge of your seat stuff still. You know, all the critics, I believe, have been silenced. That amazing rivalry re-sparked between Ferrari and Mercedes this year. You just don't know what's going to happen from race to race. And even those big teams have suffered major reliability issues. It goes to show that no one's bulletproof.